So what happens at COP26? Well, COP stands for Conference of the Parties. These climate change COPs, organised through the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, have taken place nearly every year since 1992. Hence why the forthcoming event is COP26. And Scotland is delighted to be hosting the event in Glasgow from the 11th to 12th of November. Now, many of the arrangements have yet to be finalised, and so we can't give a huge amount of detail about what this stage will look like. As it stands, it is planned to be an in-person and hybrid event. So our plan is to host a series of showcase events where there will be opportunities to present to governments and clean tech investors on the solutions to the challenges. But as we progress through the programme, the details of that will become clearer, and we will then be able to issue guidance on aspects of accommodation and logistics for the event. We would anticipate that in order to gain maximum value for the event, we would organise events over 3 or so days, and these would be in person. Of course, this is subject to whatever the applicable rules are in the context of the current pandemic. But this is an opportunity to present on a global stage at a global platform. But it's important to see COP26 as a snapshot, not the final destination. As with many of our programmes, the demo day is really the start of the collaborations between our companies and our public sector challenge sponsors. We recognise the importance of a phase that enables further collaboration. And that's why we introduced this field testing phase, a 6-month period to build on some of the connections and opportunities accrued from the previous 6 months. But to be clear, this is not a guarantee of any contract, but rather keeping the door open. Of course, if procurements do arise from this, then that's great, and that is the aim of the programme. But they would be run directly with the Alliance member.